we want to add some headers into our document. To do that, I'm going up to Insert, Header, clicking on this default. And on this header, I'm going to insert the page numbers. So I'm going to say page. Now insert fields, page number of, insert fields, page count. And I want this all to be centered, so I'm clicking the centering button. I also want to add in a footer into this document. To do that, I insert footer, default. Now on this footer, I'm going to insert a field again, but this time I want to add in the path and the file name so everyone working with this knows where this document came from. So I'm going into the other. Now in my document tab, I'm looking for file name. And here we have path with file name. Inserting that shows, and I gotta close it, shows we're on the C drive, under the Frugal Computer Guide desktop, and the file name. I also want to add a date to this document. To do that, I'm going to insert fields, and there's a date here, and we'll come back to that one in a minute. I'm going to other, going into the date, we've got a fixed date and a date. Let's take a look. The fixed date, I'm going to pick a form here, Friday, December, inserting that. Today's Friday, February 3rd, as of this recording. I'm going to make a note here that this is fixed. And then I'm also going to insert this date here, insert. Now the difference between the two is the fixed date will always stay Friday, February 3rd. That's the date of this recording, where this other date will change every time I open that document. If I open it tomorrow, Saturday, it will become February 4th. So that's the difference between the date fixed and the date. I also mentioned we'd come back to this other date here. Insert fields date. What format is that in? We're not sure. It gives us a 2/3/12, which is fine. But is it a fixed date or a date? To find out, we're going to go into View, Field Names. So it's telling us that when we insert the date, it's the date fixed, because we see our date fixed here, and then we had the date. Up here, we see page number of statistics instead of the numbers. We're going to turn that off, clicking on the field names. Now, also, while we're here looking at the view, we can also turn off the field shadings. And I'll turn them back on. Another thing we might want to do is turn off our text boundaries. Now we see that there's a header there, but we don't see how big that header is. Turning the text boundaries back on.